Hey guys, Rafael Nadal has now won his 13th French Open, an unprecedented record in men's tennis history of the likes which we may never see again. But more importantly, he's now won his 20th Grand Slam title, which ties him with good old buddy Roger Federer for the most Grand Slam titles by any male tennis player in history. Nadal also reached it being 5 years younger than Roger and 2 years younger at the same point of their careers. Roger won his 20th when he was 36 years old. Now this won't be an in-depth analysis like my past video on the GOAT of tennis. See the link below for that video. But look, I predicted anyways years ago that Novak Djokovic will still end up with the most slams by the end of his career. I won't get into that right now. I just wanted to highlight a couple key points again why I believe Nadal is often overlooked in the GOAT debate, and that's why I need to remind fans of these important facts. Mind you, both Roger and Novak have their own great cases for GOAT, and they are all deserving of that title, so I don't disagree that Roger or Novak is also the GOAT. But again, here's why Nadal is to me. People forget that pre-2011, in Federer's prime, when he ruled the world and was untouchable, setting all kinds of records, Nadal at 18 years old actually beat him. In fact, Nadal beat Roger a lot. He's never trailed Roger in the head-to-head battle. Nadal's rise had to go up against prime Roger Federer, and he managed to collect 6 slams by the end of 2010. Djokovic, while being only 1 year younger than Nadal, only managed to have 1 slam in the same time period. From 2011 to present day 2020, we enter Novak's prime and the decline of Roger Federer. Even in this prime era of Djokovic, Nadal still won 14 slams to Novak's 16. It's hardly a domination, but the edge goes to Novak. But keep in mind, even up to this point in 2020, Nadal still had the best overall winning percentage, became the only player to win multiple slams on all surfaces, and did all of this in fewer opportunities and matches due to injuries and missed time. In other words, he accomplished and did more with less. I have always argued that Nadal had the most difficult path or the highest degree of difficulty in his career, being that he had prime Roger Federer when he first entered tennis to beat. Then he had to go through prime Djokovic the rest of his career. There's never been a point or time in his career where he didn't have a prime GOAT to oppose him the entire way through his career, from start at 18 years old to finish, whenever that is. Djokovic is still going to be in or near prime form despite the 1 year age difference, which I won't get into now. The greatest tennis rivalry was Federer. And it was. But then, once Rafa pretty much took over Roger consistently, the next greatest tennis rivalry became Djokovic-Nadal. To this day, it stands as the greatest rivalry in men's tennis. So in other words, the common denominator in this is Nadal was the guy in both of the so-called greatest rivalries in tennis. Not Roger, not Novak, Rafa. He's the only one of the three who literally took on the prime forms of Roger and Novak his entire career. The other two haven't quite had that. Head to head, while Djokovic still leads it now at 29-27, people forget that Nadal actually led the head to head for 9 years from 2006 to late 2015. It wasn't until late 2015 that Novak finally took the head to head lead and has had it for the past 4 years. Nadal's very first match against prime Roger Federer was a win, so since he was 18, he's never trailed the head to head with Roger for 16 years. It is currently 24-16. I just want to say how much respect I have for Nadal and what he has had to overcome with his career-threatening injuries and how he has had to adjust his game to find success on the other surfaces, which he has. People forget he's made it to 6 Australian Open finals, even though he's only won it once. He's had incredible success at Wimbledon also, much more than just the 2 slams that he has there, and of course, 4 slams in the US Open. Most experts thought Nadal, with his style of play, the injuries that plagued his career, would never be able to last and play this well at 34 years old. He's battled and he's proven the naysayers wrong time and time again. There's no question to me he's the GOAT, and maybe in a future video I'll expand the analysis more, but I just wanted to keep this one short. So feel free to share your comments down below in the comment section. If you like the video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more. And until next time.